So that's how you begin to change the school of thought. Leading from any level in the chain of command. If you're leading, if you're doing the right things for the right reasons, that's going to spread. So when the classic example, I talk about it all the time, is if you're exercising extreme ownership, if you're saying, you know what, I got this, it was a mistake made, it was my fault, that spreads. If you're humble, that spreads. If you have an open mind, that spreads. If you're being aggressive, not aggressive towards other people, but if you're being aggressive in pursuit of your goal, that spreads. It takes battle after battle after battle, and guess what? You don't win them all. It's got to be a campaign. It's not like World War II was not one battle. World War I was not one battle. It's a campaign. It takes battle after battle after battle, and guess what? You don't win them all. You lose some of them. And so you're going to, on this campaign, you're going to win and you're going to lose. But you got to have the persistence and the patience and the persuasiveness to continue. Stand and fight. Fight against weakness and against fear. Then fight against time and decay. Fight back. Go down swinging. Give every day everything you've got. And when you face a challenge, even something where you don't believe you can win, maybe it's a situation where you cannot win. Remember this. You have nothing to lose. So stand up and go forward and go out in a blaze of glory.
You have to understand that your losses, and this is why I want you to look at them every day, because your losses fuel you in a way, the way that your winning can never fuel you. When you take an L, you take the right L, you like, I'm gonna be very cautious on that next move I make, if you're smart. So number one, every single day, I want you to go to bed at night, stop playing games, and be honest about the wins and the losses. So I always remember where I came from. I remember all the L's I took, because when you forget the L's, that's when you like, you big and bad. I remember. Those are the ones, man. Those are the ones that humble me.
Tough times produce strong men. Strong men produce good times. Good times produce weak men. Weak men produce tough times.
Yes.
If that's the truth, which phase are we in today?
Well, if you think about it historically, you have to say that we're in good times. I mean, that doesn't mean everything about the current times are good, and of course life is always tenuous and difficult. I think life is never easy, even under relatively positive conditions, but it's very difficult to make the case that we're not in good times. And I especially think that's true if you look at the world globally. The American working class, and maybe the Western working class in general, paid a very large price for enriching the rest of the world. You know, I mean, China's come up in a miraculous way in the last 40 years, mm-hmm. South Korea, India,
yep.
While the entire, all of Southeast Asia, and increasingly Africa too, because the fastest growing economies in the world are now in sub-Saharan Africa. And that's produced a tremendous competition for working class people in the West. But speaking on a global level, there's never been a better time for the majority of people to be alive. And the future, although we're vulnerable and terrible things can always happen to us, it's hard to make a case that the future doesn't look comparatively positive. So it'll depend on how we manage it, you know, which is partly why it's so necessary for everyone here and everyone in general to put their lives together, because we're becoming extremely technologically sophisticated, and the world is changing at an incredibly rapid rate. And the only way we're going to be able to manage that in a positive way is if each of us, or as many of us as possible, are capable of making wise and careful and truthful decisions. And if we do that, then, you know, maybe things can continue to improve.